In news overseas, U.S. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi and her family traumatized by last Friday's attack on her husband. President Joe Biden has condemned the incident as he points out possible links to the January 6 attack on the U.S. Capitol. Our North American News Bureau Chief TJ Manotok now joins us with the latest from California. TJ, this seems like a very brazen attack.
It is, Mike, and a very shocking attack indeed that happened on early Friday morning as you all in the Philippines were dealing with the bad weather on Saturday. The U.S. and San Francisco in particular woke up to this shocking and brazen attack in downtown San Francisco, about 10 minutes away from it, in this very affluent area called Pacific Heights. Right behind me, that orange red brick home right there is the house of House Speaker Nancy Pelosi. At 2:30 in the morning, the suspect, David DePape, broke into the back of this house just by breaking the glass of their rear door and gets inside the home and immediately starts apparently looking for Speaker Pelosi herself by shouting out, "Where's Nancy? Where's Nancy?" And then he eventually encounters her husband, 82-year-old Paul Pelosi. It's at that point that Paul Pelosi knew that this intruder had ill intentions beyond just any, you know, random burglary. He discreetly calls 911 without the intruder catching notice. And he was giving code basically to the 911 dispatcher by saying things like, "What are you doing here? Who are you? What are you going to do to me?" And it was that kind of coded conversation that Mr. Pelosi gave to his 911 dispatcher when he put his phone away that triggered the police to come over to this house. And the moment they got in here, they went inside and they caught Mr. DePape trying to tie up Mr. Pelosi. And then when he saw the police were there, he struck him on the head with a hammer before he was subdued. And after that, Mr. Pelosi was rushed to the hospital. And as reports had it on Saturday, he actually underwent brain surgery for a skull fracture, but reports are saying that he is recovering fine at the moment. Meanwhile, Speaker Nancy Pelosi took a while before she spoke out and gave a statement, which she did, though, around midday Saturday. And she thanked everyone for their support and their prayers, but she did say this: "Our children, our grandchildren are heartbroken and traumatized by the life-threatening attack on our pop." Now, the suspect, Christian, David DePape, has had footprints of conspiracy theories all over the internet, from the big lie that the 2020 election was stolen from Donald Trump, the COVID vaccine conspiracies, to the QAnon conspiracies as well. Authorities are expecting to file formal charges of attempted homicide or even attempted murder. It's been back and forth discussion of which particular case will be filed against him. Among that as well, elderly abuse, among others. There may even be a parallel federal investigation on this particular case. Now, today, the latest developments had some bizarre twists and turns. Elon Musk, who just recently bought Twitter 3 days ago, actually tweeted out an ounce of doubt as he shared an article from a right-wing conspiratorial newspaper that had an opinion article saying that there were sources saying that Mr. Pelosi and Mr. DePape actually met in a gay bar in San Francisco and that this was a gay lover's quarrel. So hours after that post by Mr. Musk to his 112 million followers, it was mysteriously deleted without him issuing any apology. Meanwhile, President Biden on Saturday and on Friday, who has been going around helping campaign for the Democrats in the midterms, did touch on the topic, and he was obviously visibly very angry and very disturbed as he condemned the attacks. Let's listen to what President Biden had to say.
"This is despicable. There's no place in America. There's too much violence, political violence, too much hatred, too much vitriol. And what makes us think that one party can talk about stolen elections, COVID being a hoax, there's all a bunch of lies, and it not affect people who may not be so well balanced? You know, it's reported that the same chant was used by this guy they have in custody that was used on January 6th in the attack on the U.S. Capitol. I'm not making this up. This has been reported. I can't guarantee it. I can tell you what's being reported. The chant was, 'Where's Nancy? Where's Nancy? Where's Nancy?'"
Now, Mike, this is so reminiscent of that attack at the Capitol, the insurrection of January 6th, because aside from those insurrectionists looking for Vice President Mike Pence, who they said they wanted to hang, they were also specifically searching for Nancy Pelosi. Now, this incident, Mike, is coming 10 days before the U.S. midterm elections, the hotly contested midterm elections, where the power in Congress could very well sway to the other side through the Republican Party. The Department of Homeland Security and the FBI, just 2 days ago, actually before this attack, issued a joint release to all police departments across the country, warning them of potential violence before and after the elections, and in even in some cases, possibly some lone wolf attacks like this one, wherein just one individual will do something absolutely insane to try to sow some violence or disrupt the peaceful conduct of elections. Mike.
TJ, lots to unpack in your report, but what struck me was that how can an intruder actually just break open the window of the house of a House Speaker there in the United States? It's unthinkable here in the Philippines.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we in the Philippines are so used to knowing that, you know, public officials have a lot of security, sometimes even some private security that they amass on their own. Apparently, that's been a contentious issue that congressmen are provided with Capitol Police security wherever they go. Mm-hmm. Not their families. Only when that congressman or congresswoman is around do they have that security. So there's no federal funding for the extended families of the representatives who are elected in the lower house. Now, what's also kind of odd that some people may presume that at least if you live in an active community like this is called Pacific Heights, by the way, Mike. It's like the Ayala Alabang or Forbes Park of San Francisco, but it's not gated at all. It's not a gated community. They did not have an alarm system. I mean, some homes here, they may not have security, but they have an alarm system that you break a window. Immediately, that system will call 911. Interestingly enough, the Pelosi home did not have that. So it necessitated Mr. Pelosi to make that very discreet and sharp call to 911 to eventually, what people have been saying, save his life. If not for that dispatcher figuring out that there was an intruder in the home just by overhearing that conversation between Mr. Pelosi and Mr. DePapi, things could have been very different.
All right. Thank you so much for that update. Our North America Bureau Chief, TJ Manotok.